Greetings and salutations. I'm Janet from World Anvil, and this is our quick guide tutorial for Manuscripts, the World Anvil novel writing software where you can write, edit, export, and digitally publish your novels, books, and stories. The software integrates completely with your writing workflow, so at every stage of the writing process, you have all the information you need in a single interface. You can use this writing software for novels, serial fiction, short story compilations, or even for planning out your campaign setting book for release. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a manuscript, how to set up your writing space the way you like it, to write your story, and then publish it. Are you ready? It's time to light up the forge. You'll find the Manuscripts interface here on the left-hand menu bar. If you can't see the Manuscripts option on the menu, you may need to activate the Novel Writing Software module. Click on your avatar at the top right and select Account Features. Then select which features you want active. By the way, you can use the quick navigator, Artemis, to get anywhere on World Anvil faster. Try it out by typing Open Account Features or write List Manuscripts to go to the Manuscripts homepage. To create a new manuscript, first check that you've got the correct world selected. You can change between worlds at any time on the top left of the interface, like this. The Manuscript software connects your manuscript to a world, and you can search through that world as you write. So this is an important step. Finally, click the plus button to create a new manuscript. This is what you'll see whenever you create a new manuscript. A little good luck message from us to you. Click the green button to continue. The next step is to set up your writing space the way you like it. Click here on the name of your manuscript. It will automatically be called the name of the manuscript to get to your manuscript settings. Here in the Basic Settings tab, you can edit the title and the cover, add a blurb, and choose language and genres. If you choose to digitally publish your manuscript on World Anvil, the genres and language you choose will help people find your work. Remember that published doesn't mean public. You can release your manuscripts exclusively to your readers and beta readers, Patreon supporters, or customers. And here in the Access tab, you can set all of that up. I've linked the Access Rights Quick Guide video at the top of this video, so check that out for more information. With labels, you can, you guessed it, label your chapters and scenes. This is a great way to keep track of which scenes and chapters have already been edited, beta read, or proofread. You can edit the name and color of your labels here. Labels and writing stages are a very personal thing. Some examples of labels you might like to use could be plotted, first draft, edits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and as many as you need, beta readers, and ready for release. Here on the right-hand panel, you also have some options to customize your writing space. With the color palette tab, you can change how the editor looks and feels. Change the writing interface fonts, background color, paragraph rules, and even add extra CSS to completely customize your writing environment. Once you're done, remember to refresh the page so the settings can take effect. Here, you can see day-by-day stats of your manuscript's word count progress and track likes and comments. Use the monetization options to link your published manuscript to your Patreon, Ko-fi, and other accounts. You can also add a marketing message here. With the final tab, you can export your manuscript or link it to your World Anvil world, but we'll get to that later. Now your manuscript writing interface is set up the way you like it, let's talk about the main editing interface. I'll collapse the menu bar using this hamburger icon to give us more space. By the way, you can always do that on World Anvil at any time. Here on the left is the list of all your chapters and scenes. Scenes are your actual text documents. Chapters are like folders, which help keep you organized. You can have as many scenes in a chapter as you like, and you can drag and drop everything around in this sidebar to reorder it. But scenes are where the action is. It's where your text will go. So let's talk about those next. To edit a scene, simply click on it on the left-hand side and start writing here in the text editor. It works just like any standard word processor. Click this ellipses button to see even more options for formatting your text. Clicking this green plus button will automatically create a new scene beneath the one you have selected. You can also click the drop-down to create a new scene or chapter and then drag it into place. If you want to create image sections, if you're creating a comic book, for example, or adding illustrations to your book, then you can create image sections from here too. Just select which picture you want from the image library. As you're writing, you'll probably want to reference your plots, characters, and world-building information. Now, this is the really amazing thing about manuscripts. You can search not only your whole manuscript, but the complete world attached to it, and all from the same interface. Once you've searched a term here in the search bar, you'll see your results appear here. In the manuscript search, you can see every instance of your search term, and you can also replace all instances with a new word. This is great if you've decided to change a character name or item name halfway through. Clicking a result will take you directly to that scene, and you can use Control F to locate the instance of your search term within that scene. Here on the second tab, you can see all instances of your search term within your world setting on World Anvil. Click the result, and the vignette of the article will appear here at the top for you to reference. You can also quick edit right here in the interface. That's perfect for adding small details you just thought of as you were writing. It's a great way to keep your series Bible updated as you go, and also to reference your series Bible as you're writing your novel. Use the close buttons on the article showcase and the search results panel to remove them from the interface. Here on the right-hand side of your selected scene are the meta details. Your scene will automatically be named after the first few words of text, but you can rename it right here. You can also add a synopsis, what's happening during the scene, which will be great when you're reviewing your scenes to quickly understand what happens where. I'll show you more about that in a moment. Finally, you can add notes, which are a great place to track edits you plan to make later. In this second tab, you can denote meta information like point of view character or scene location. If these exist as articles within your linked world, they'll appear in the dropdown as you start typing, and you can link them in. To delete a scene, you can either drag it into the bin like this, or delete it from this last tab here. You can also duplicate a scene here. This is very helpful for edits and versioning of your manuscript. If you're ready to read your scene back, click Read at the top right. It'll present your scene as read only. Click Write to go back to write mode. For a distraction-free mode, you can collapse the left and or right menu bar from this dropdown on the top left. This makes the interface really customizable so you can choose what you have in front of you when you write. And you can bring everything back from the same menu. Now let's check out chapters, the organizational units of your manuscript. Click on a chapter to get a detailed list of scenes within it. You can see the basic meta information you've added to each scene, as well as the word count. By clicking Review, you can see the synopses and the publication state of each scene in the chapter. You can also add scene texts and chapter folders here really quickly. So this review page is a great place to set up a new manuscript quickly with lots of chapters and scenes. If you're importing material into manuscripts, this is the fastest place to set everything up. By clicking Read, you can scroll through all the scenes in your selected chapter. They'll be linked together as they'll appear in your book. On the right-hand side, you can set meta information for a whole chapter, just like you can for individual scenes. Once you've polished your work, you'll be ready to publish. Either export your work or publish digitally on the World Anvil platform. To export your manuscript, click on the title to get to Manuscript Settings. On the right-hand side, this Settings tab allows you to export to text-rich HTML. it looks like this. From here, you can simply copy-paste into your ebook converter or into Google Docs if you want to convert to PDF or DocX. We have even more export options coming with our manuscripts upgrade, scheduled for next year. If you want to publish digitally, you can publish on the World Anvil platform itself. Our sleek, modern publishing interface is a great way to deliver content to customers and fans and to attract new readers. To publish on the World Anvil platform, click on your first chapter folder on the left-hand side. Then select the Settings tab from the meta information. Here you can see the privacy settings and subscriber groups this chapter will be available to. The first chapter you publish will also publish your manuscript information, your cover, your blurb, and everything else. Then you can share it with your beta readers, your customers, or the whole world. Keep in mind that everything in manuscripts is private by default, so you'll need to set these public one by one when you're ready to release them. For more information about how access rights work in World Anvil, I've linked in our quick guide to access rights up at the top and in the description. Once you've selected the state you want the manuscript to be released in, click the green button to publish your first chapter and your manuscript. And this is how a published manuscript looks. Sleek, huh? You can embed audio, like an audiobook or thematic music, at the top of each chapter. You can add that here in the chapter settings, under Rich Media URL. This custom marketing message appears here on the main page and at the end of each chapter. You can add it here in the tab of your manuscript settings. You might like to include a call to action for people to support you, buy your books, or check out your world. And if you want to explore other people's manuscripts in the community, check out the Manuscripts community page. You can get to that via the browse button. Look at all them shiny books. As always, if you have suggestions for the future of our novel writing software, please throw those into the comments below. We're always trying to make World Anvil a better and more inspiring place to world build and to write. And if you're looking for more details on how to use manuscripts, check out our documentation, the World Anvil Codex, at worldanvil.com/codex. I've linked both the Codex Guide to Manuscripts and the blog version of this video in the description too. Or you can join our Discord server, worldanvil.com/discord. where you can ask questions live in our help channel. And make sure you subscribed to this YouTube channel. That's youtube.com/worldanvil, where you can find more World Anvil tutorials and quick guides and inspiring world building content. Now grab your hammer and go world build.